This video is sponsored by Lens Studio. We made the gravity gun in augmented reality. In this video, we're going to break down exactly how we did it. The gravity gun from Half-Life 2 is an iconic game mechanic. You can pick up any object and launch it across the room. The gravity gun would go on to inspire a whole generation of physics-based tools and video games. And today, we're going to show you how to build your own gravity gun in Lens Studio. We're going to use raycasting to grab a 3D object, physics to throw it, and UI buttons to control it all. Project files are downloadable below. First thing we're going to do in Lens Studio is start a new project. Wait for that to open up. And when it does, we're going to go ahead and save it as Gravity Gun. Click Save. And let's change our lens preview to the rear camera. Let's find a world object controller in the objects panel. It's under helper scripts. There it is. And as soon as that loads in, we're going to delete the examples that come along with it. The big red panda from the objects panel here, as well as the resources panel. We're not going to need that. Let's select our matte shadow. And we're going to scale it up to 500 on the X, Y, and Z. Now let's add a physics collider component to this scene object and set that to box. Let's go ahead and save our project so we don't lose any of our progress. Next thing we're going to do is select our camera and add a device tracking component to this scene object. Let's adjust our camera's far setting to 10,000 so we can see further. Now in the resources panel, let's import file, select our tutorial assets, and look for the gravity gun container. This is a Lens Studio object file, so when we import it, it's going to come in with its positioning and materials already applied. All right, here it comes. Now let's go ahead and see if it's working right. Perfect. Okay, let's import the crate as well. Select our crate. This is also a Lens Studio object, so when we import it, it's already going to be positioned. We don't have to worry about that part. Let's go ahead and child it to the World Object Controller. Let's save our project again. Okay, next thing we're going to do in the resources panel here is make a new folder, and we're going to name this Button Images. Now hit that plus sign again, and we're going to import some images for our buttons. These are going to be in the tutorial assets, grab and throw. Now we're going to add a screen image in our objects panel. I'm going to rename that to Buttons. Rename the image to Grab. And with that selected, let's take our grab image and drop it in the texture panel. And let's manually resize it to fit our needs on the screen. That looks pretty good. Let's pin it to that location and let's add an interaction component to it. That's going to allow us to recognize touch events on it. Let's set the camera to the orthographic camera. That's where 2D elements live. And let's add our mesh visual. That's going to be the actual image for this, the grab image. All right, looking good. Let's go ahead and save our project again. Next thing we're going to do is duplicate that screen image. I'm going to rename it Throw. And let's reposition it next to this button. Next, we're going to change the image texture to the throw image. And we're going to change our mesh visual to this new image, throw. Okay. Perfect. Let's save one more time. Next thing we're going to do is set up some tween animations on these buttons. To do that, we're going to bring in a tween manager. You're going to find that under helper scripts again. There it is. It'll take a moment to load. It's going to come in with a few examples, and we're not going to need those in this instance. So when it loads in, first we're going to move it to the top of the hierarchy. And that's something you got to do with the tween manager every time you use it. That way everything below it can use it as a resource. Let's go ahead and delete that example and the example in the resources panel just to keep things clean. And we're going to take a tween transform with the grab image selected and apply it to that scene object. Let's rename this tween grab tap. We don't want it to play automatically. Let's set it to a scale tween. And we are going to scale from 1 on the XYZ to 0.8 on the XYZ. So it gets a little smaller on a tap. Let's set the time to 0.3. And yeah, the easing looks good. Let's go ahead and copy this. You got to click up here to copy a component. Click up at the top of the component. All right, we're going to paste it down here. Let's rename this to grab reset.